Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy. Please tell me you got that, Jamie. Please tell me you got that. Then everyone, so you're joining me today at Packington Somers Fishery, where I'm going to be doing some of my all-time favourite fishing in the whole wide world, and that is pellet waggler fishing. So I'm going to be covering two different kinds of pellet waggler. That is sort of like a fixed mugging pellet waggler and your traditional pellet waggler, you know, where you're sort of feeding bait, casting into it, 15-20 second, same again, repeat the process, or winding back, feed it, casting it into it. It's a fantastic fishery, this one. We're on the Molins Lake today here at Packington, and oh my days, there's some massive fishing here. Like, walking up this morning, I'm thinking, right, I've got to go there, There was a massive shoal of carp in front of us. They've drifted out a little bit now, unfortunately. It just drifted with the wind, but it's set to be an absolute scorching day as well, folks. All snarled up in Ambrosial air, you know, it's going to get up to like 30, 31 degrees today. So we've got here nice and early just to hopefully give us the best chance of catching these great big, wise, crafty fish. Which leads me on to the first way that I'm going to sort of like target them if I do see them more cruising. It's more, I mean, don't get me wrong, it'll work throughout all your session, but it's more sort of, you know, the mid part of your match or a session, you know, the midday when, you know, nothing wants to feed, but you can see them sort of like cruising in the water. Obviously, we're not fishing a pole, we're fishing a rod and line, which for me is a little bit more effective because you ain't got the pole or anything there to spook them, especially on clear, bright days like this. So, first things first, I'm going to go right from the start. And my days, folks, our new rods, these are Pyrex Waggler rods, they're just like ridiculous. So, I've got the 11 foot version on for this particular style of fishing, which is a mugging pellet waggler. Reason being is a little bit of a shorter rod. I might not be casting as far. Obviously, I can get to the far bank, no problem at all, but I'm looking to catch these fish basically anywhere from sort of like under my feet, you know, to across the lake. So smaller rods, just can guide it, you know, sort of like I've got trees, you know, just to my left here, I can maybe give it a little flick under there and it's not too cumbersome. So 11 foot float rod. Now mainline wise, I suppose like with traditional waggler fishing, I've always been a massive advocate of using really fine mainlines, you know, 0.16, 0.18 at the most. Now, for me mugging waggler, I'll use a 0.18 mainline, which is, I've got the 0.20, I've got my other one, float max. So I've got 0.18 on for this one, simply because we're using lighter wagglers. My other setup, which we'll go through in a bit, that's got a thicker mainline on because I'm using heavier wagglers to get the distance that I want should any wind or anything get up. So first things first, 0.18 mainline coupled with around a sort of like size 3000 up to 4000 size reel at the absolute most. You don't want to be using big reels for this because bigger reels too cumbersome. You don't need sort of 5 or 6000 reels. That's for chucking feeders miles, folks. You don't need them for this. So 3-4000 at the absolute most. Right, let's go through the actual setup. Let me bring my rod around this way. So what I've done, so this is set up a little bit different to what I'd normally do. In there, it's completely fixed on my line. So dead easy. I've got the pellet waggler stops kit. So obviously comes, like you see there, folks, that's how it comes. You get the stop above your line, the swivel, and then two stops below it. So I've slid all them on. And I've tied, I've just gone through four times, nice strong knot, and I've tied it. So you can see there that if Jamie zooms in on that, you can see that that's fixed. That bottom stop there is fixed. It can't go below that knot. Now, the reason I've got that is I'm not interested in sort of like changing the depth with this one. It's purely for mugging. Now, what I'll do is I'll put a long hook length on, you know, sort of 3, 4, 5 foot hook length. At the minute, I've got a 3 foot hook length on. Now what I want to be doing with this is obviously sighting the fish, casting to it, but obviously dropping my waggler short. So if the fish is swimming out this way, I want to drop my waggler here, feathering the rig so that my hook bait gets trajected past my float and lands hopefully somewhere near the fish. The beauty of this style of fishing is obviously because it's fixed, it can't possibly move. It's nice and quick, and it doesn't spook the fish. Whereas if that was, you know, free to run like my other one is, and you know, I've only got a short hook length on, the float's landing too close to the fish, so that can become a problem and spook these big, wise, crafty, clever fish. I've seen some right big ghosts, I'm sure they'll be a nightmare to catch, but we're going to go try for them. So that's how I'd always, always set me mugging waggler rig up, if you like. Usually minimum is sort of like three foot hook length, but by all means going up to sort of 4 or 5. We've got quite a bit of colour in the water today, so it's not too bad, but if the water was clear, folks, by all means just go longer hook lengths. Hook length is, we've got 0.20 AccuPower as hook length. You know, it stood the test of time. It's just, for me, I don't think there's a better line on the market than it. It's really, really strong, really robust, and that is coupled with a size 14 KKH hook, you know, KKH, KKM hooks, and we've just got a medium band on there, because I'm just going to be banding an 8mm pellet. You know, I've got red pellets, but it's fishery pellets only here, you know, obviously, so they're so used to sort of like the normal traditional Coppins pellets, but I'm just going to be switching between them. But KKH hooks are a must for the size of the fish in here. Oop, we're all snarled up in line here, folks, never mind me, get that away. Yeah, KKH is a brilliant for sort of smaller carp, I'd say. I mean, you'll catch everything on them, but it's more suited for me for sort of like F1s and smaller carp. When you know it's sort of bigger carp you're after, which here I'm the massive in here, I've fished it before, you've got to go that little bit heavier. Obviously, if I'm thinking that, you know, hook's a little bit too big, too obtrusive, falling a little bit too fast or whatever, then obviously I can scale down to a KKH. And I've got some of them pre-tied, folks. That does not bother me in the slightest. So that's mugging waggler complete. The next one is your more sort of traditional pellet waggler style of fishing. Now, this style of fishing's been around for years and years, and blooming heck, it catches some fish, but you've got to be doing it right to catch them. You know, obviously conditions, they're not ideal today, but where I'm casting across to the far bank, you know, with it being slightly undercut, that's what I'm looking to target. You know, obviously feeding, casting into it, the fish will come to that noise. If I've not had anything within 15 seconds at the absolute most, folks, I'm bringing it back and just repeating the process. Sometimes you'll see me cast without feeding, because what happens is the fish will just get used to that noise going in. So if the next noise they hear after you've fed is the sound of your waggler and your pellet landing, they just tend to zone in on it, and you know, you can have great days on it. It's a fabulous way of fishing. So exactly the same range of rods as a Pyrex, but 12 foot this time. Now, I'd always go minimum of 12 foot. Very rare I'd use a 13 foot for pellet waggler fishing. For me, a 13 foot rod's more sort of for your traditional sort of waggler fishing, but the 12 foot for me does absolutely everything for this style of pellet waggler fishing. And these rods, they're just ridiculous. Normal 12 foot rods are two piece, but with having this rod, it's actually three piece. It just, the action you get in the rod just bends all the way down to the boat. I can't get enough of them. I just want to use them everywhere. I'm not going to pole fish from now on, folks. I'm just going to fish waggler everywhere. So mainline wise, remember me saying it's a little bit thicker. Exactly the same size reel, the centre is 320, but mainline is 0.20. Simply because it's going to be going through a lot more rigour, if you like, you know what I mean? I'm going to be casting it a lot more, I'm going to be possibly using heavier wagglers and what have you, if I want to get to the distance. So that's why I've gone for a 0.20 in the float max. The reason for float max, it does what it says, it floats on the water. I don't want to be sinking my line whatsoever. Most of the bite, certainly on this, are coming within 15 seconds, if not instantly, as soon as it hits the water. And it's exactly the same on that mugging waggler. You're chucking at fish and they should be turning around and having that bait straight away. You don't need a sinking line. Obviously, you know, it doesn't matter if you got it on, but I'd far, far recommend a floating line rather than a sinking one. So that's what we got on. 20.20 float max. Now, onto the actual setup itself. Really simple. So exactly the same as what we've got on the mugging waggler one, but if you see this one, it's free to move. I've not got it fixed. My hook length's down here somewhere. I've got a 12 inch hook length on this, which I'll talk you through in a sec, but I've set it at probably, what's that, 2 foot, 22 inches, 2 foot, just to give me an idea of what the depth's like over there. Never going in with a plummet or anything like that, because as I say, with this style of fishing, the fish take the bait straight away. You know, you're not fishing it on the bottom, if you like. If you want to fish on the bottom, just chuck a ledger bomb in, you know what I mean, bomb and pellet. But with this style of fishing, if the fish are, you know, backing off, coming into deeper water or something like that, then what I can do is obviously increase depth just by moving the stops on the float, nice and simple. Obviously, I could do that with a mugging waggler one, but for me, that's there obviously for that fixed purpose. And if I wanted to, I could come a lot shallower. So the hook length on this one is 0.20 again, exactly the same mainline, 0.20 Aki power, but it's fixed at 12 inches this time. And I've got the exact same hook on again, so it's a size 14 KKH with just a medium band on. And I'll be changing the pellets around, you know what I mean? This style of fishing lends itself to being active. I think that's why I love it so much. But I'm going to warn you now, folks, match conditions, you've got to be strict on yourself, because time just flies by. Because it's such an active method, you're feeding, casting into it, winding back, feeding, casting into it, repeating the process all the time. You know, 10, 15, 20 minutes, half an hour can just go with, like, for very little reward. But on the flip side of that, 3, 4, 5 fish, and you could be on your next net, you know what I mean? There's some massive fish to be caught on this style of fishing. You'll catch F1s on it as well. The trouble with F1s on this is they're blooming hard to hit. So if it is more F1s in the venue, you're going to catch them on it, but obviously go down more the pole route. This lends itself more to carp. Don't get me wrong, you will catch F1s on it, but it's more sort of carp and that. Bait wise, I'll talk you through everything, literally all we've got. I've got two bags of fishery on pellets, 8 mils on here, 8 mils so I can get the distance. Obviously I'm not interested in fishing a pole today, just fishing a waggler. So 8 mils to get the distance, and I've got a few. This only Robin Red hookers, 8 mils, just nice and simple. Nothing complicated, anything what we're going to do today, folks. But you've got to be strict on yourself in that you don't want to let too much time go by, certainly on the more traditional style of the pellet waggler fishing, without feeding something and without being busy, you know, changing depths, maybe feeding a few more than a few less. I tend to stick to sort of 4 to 6 pellets, feed, cast into it, just getting into that kind of rhythm. It's a fantastic way of fishing, and hopefully we're going to get snarled up in loads and loads of fish today. So I think without further ado, that's the setup's talk through. Let's go and catch some fishies. Yeah! Here we go then, folks. It's always good to get off the start pretty much straight away. So first 5 minutes I've spent mugging. I chucked this at like a carp that looked about 40 pounds, like 5 foot long, and a blooming F1's taken hit. But never mind, we're off. So I've started off like feeding straight away across, but there's so many sort of like in front of me mugging. You can just see them just under the surface. Nice F1 to start with though. 2 pounds 10 ounce. So warm them fish, blooming, that's like bath water. So just check that rig for slime or anything. And already I can still see a load of blooming carp in front of me. So I'm gonna go straight back on with a 8 mil pellet. Yeah, I thought that big one had taken it then. I'm like, should I cast to it or not? Well, I couldn't resist casting to it. I'm just gonna have this one about 16 meters here. Go for that one there. Literally all over the place, it just popped up. What is important though is obviously when you're on the mugging waggler, obviously we're not going to leave it too long, but you've got to keep that bait going in for your traditional sort of pellet waggler. It's so important. If you don't and someone else is around you feeding, it's not good. Then obviously they're going to nick your fish. I've got a couple swimming towards me here now. So what I want to do is land, obviously the float, this side of the fish, and then feather it so that my hook bait's going past it. Better off standing up. If you're allowed to stand up, better to stand up. I'm just going to do a sideways one on this one. They're coming slightly to the noise, but they're just not taking it. But you can see how quick you can get out of the habit of feeding. Oh, there's a shoal of sort of 5 or 6 there. Cast into them. I'm going to take it, casted it into the shoal, but I think it's just moved on. Go on. But literally sort of 10 seconds is absolute most on this, folks. Don't leave it too long. And what is important is glasses. Polarised glasses are an absolute must for this game. Got to have your glasses on. And the other thing I'm using as well for the first time is our brand new catapults, folks. So we do, that one of them will take it. Go on. Oh, I just flicked it. I thought I wanted taken it. Ugh. Yeah, I've got a light to medium, a medium to heavy. So I've got the medium to heavy one that I'm using for over there. getting that bait across. It's probably 30 yards over there, and getting them across, no problem at all. Lovely. Go on. Go on. So many just under the surface. At least you can see them on camera, but there's a lot of carp here. Just maintain that feeding though. I mean, normally, like max condition, if there's this many, you've got to have a go for them. This is another pile of fish coming in here. You've got to have a go for them, but oh, go on, you turn around for it, turn around for it, turn around for it. No, he's not. I thought he was going to turn around for it then. Yeah, you've got to have a go for him and just take sort of like 10 minutes out, you know, one of these fish. Go on, go on. If they're coming to the plot, then brilliant. But if they're not, then that's where that longer hookland will come into it. Right, I've got a group of sort of three or four swimming away from me, so I can cast it in front of them like that. Hopefully one of them will turn around and have it going. Oh, I thought one of them had it then. Yeah, boy! So when there's like a few together, casting at singles sometimes work, but when there's a few together, they'll have it much more confident. If it's another folks. So you see, I'm still feeding over there, even though we're playing a fish, so important. I think it might be another big F1, you know. Oh, it is another F1. They look like carp we're casting to. Obviously, the F1s are just following them around. Oh, lovely action on these rods, folks. Blooming heck. Get a bend on it. So we've got the 11-foot one at the minute. Look at that. Beautiful. A lot of fish. Oh, it's a massive one just here. Some of them always look too big. You know what I mean? See when I'm playing them, again, always angles. Never directly above them. Always angles on the fish. Not putting a net in today, folks. No way. It's just too warm to put nets in. Fish are too hot. So a quick unhook and then quick show you and then release. So again, you still see I'm feeding that line. 40, I'm going to say 4 to 8 pellets. What are we playing out with this one for? Come on. 4 to 8 pellets is about right. So angry just after spawning these fish, folks. So, fish into your lap first, and then I always have back wind on, but what I'll do, tuck that under my leg, put the anti reverse on, and we'll go to unhook it. Proper nailed it, that one. I say I thought it was one of them carp, chucked to like 4 or 5 carp, but little ones are taking it. Beautiful little fish, so them. Stunning little fish. Not a bad start, is it? Now, I'm not seeing as many now, because obviously, probably still there. And that's again where the help of these glasses will come into it. You know, just canting all that glare out, but because it's gone a bit more overcast, I'm not seeing as many. Still going to have it set up though, just in case. Just in case. Oh yeah, there's one there. I'm not seeing as many groups though, so I'll be changing over to, oh, there's one just around here. Like a meerkat, aren't they, folks? I'll be changing over to traditional waggler. Not traditional waggler, I'm blooming obsessed with traditional waggler, aren't I? Pellet waggler. I had a few signs over there now. Probably F1's coming into it. There's a carp there. Go on. Go on. Go on then. I was right past it, that. Oh, he's so excited, folks. I love it. It's so good. When you get them great big ones on it, it's just like, not better, another one there. That sight casting. But it's so important with that longer hook length that your float's landing this side, there's another two coming in there, that your float's landing this side, and you're feathering it, so that your bait goes the direction of the fish. Go on, got it, got it. Got to have it, go on, yep, yep. Nope, not having it, not having it. So just thought I'd bring it back, get some more pellets across there. They went a bit wayward with that plumbing. That wind, that's better. There's one a little bit further out. And obviously the beauty of our floats as well, folks, and the connection, the setup we've got, if they are, you know, a little bit further out, then you just put a bigger float on. There's two down here. Oops, it walked out landing it. Just put a bigger float on to get the distance, but look at that one there. Go on. He's going to have it. Go on then. Go on then. Oh, is he not have it? Oh, we had a little dink on it. I thought that would have taken it then. Yeah, a little bit further out, just put an heavier float on. So I'm just under the surface here. They look like a pair of F1s then, but we'll see what they are. Nope, that's no good. See me float and me upweight landed together. Don't want that at all. I want that. Go on then. Go on then. I want my float to land obviously this side and my pellet to go past it. Keep that up. Just get into rhythm, but you can see how quick, you know, time can go. Potentially a little reward, you know what I mean? Come on, the fishies. It's only good this when you can like see one, you know. Obviously you've casted it one, 10 seconds you look around and you can see another one. That's when it's good, that's when it lends itself to. If you're not seeing them, he's going to go down on it then. Go on. If you're not seeing them every go, you know, 10 seconds you bring it back, you can't see another one, come off it. Then just get into the normal weir fishing, traditional weir fishing. But at the minute, I've got piles of fish everywhere. Another one over there. Go on then. Go on then. It's the first time, oh no, I'm not. I'm just going to say that's the first time I've gone in and not seen the fish, but I've just got another pile coming through. Incidentally, what will make a difference is every sort of few minutes changing your pellet. It will start to wear a bit, you know what I mean? Start to take on a little bit of water and start to go a bit crumbly. So that's not what you want. You don't want it falling too fast. Go on. See like the big shapes, big shades, and then there's like little baby ones underneath them. Look at them there, which are obviously the F1s. That looks a big one, doesn't it? Oh, is he going to turn around for it? Go on then. How has he not had it? Get me bloody float then. Oh, he's far looked. He's fell off. Get me float then, folks. Not what we want. Not what we want. Another one there though. Go on. Oh, he's speeding through. When you get these fast ones coming through, they don't normally have it. He was going fast with the. He might have it that time though. He was going fast with like one or two fish behind him, he'd have it, but on its own, they very rarely have it. God, it's exciting stuff, this. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. Too firing out that way. Go on. Yeah, you've got to be strict on yourself. Don't spend too long on it. Another cruiser out there. A bit too far for this float though. So I'm seeing it out at the minute. I'm seeing enough sort of for this size of float. You know, oh, look at that one. None are more than sort of, you know, 20 metres away, which can comfortably get with this float. I want a lighter float as possible, really. I don't want to be using too heavy a float that can potentially, you know, spook the fish. Can I reach that one there? Go on. Nope. Probably been cast at millions of times, these fish. So I'm getting to the stage now where I'm not seeing loads moving. When you get to this stage, this is obviously when it's time to come off this and go on to the more traditional way of fishing. Because obviously this is just a sight thing, you know what I mean? The ducks, oh there's one. No, he's not interested at all. Two goes at him. Sometimes you can keep having a go for them and then they'll take it. It's sort of like angering them into taking it. Let's try a red one. Try a red hookbait, if that makes a difference. Sometimes it can. There's a grip over there, but I think they're a bit Yeah, they're swimming the wrong way. On other days, you know, you put it of everyone and everyone takes it. You do a silly weight. Depends how often the blooming been caught on it, that's all. Right, come on, come on. I'm not seeing as many come through now, folks. Obviously, match conditions. I probably would be off this now. There's not enough there now to warrant fishing this. You know, whereas before, I've seen sort of like groups of twos, three and four swimming through at the minute. I'm not seeing anywhere. There's another one down here, but that tree's in the way. And it's in his peg next door. I think he'd be a bit angry, wouldn't he, if I caught his fish? It'll just, well, on this bit of a rest period, just keeping that bait going in. Just while I see some more swim through. Again, I wouldn't be doing it for too long if I was in a match. There's another one over there. I can't let me see him. Yeah, there's another one there. It's right on its line. Go on. Go on then. Go on. Sometimes a little change bait can make all the difference. Other times not though. But sometimes it can, yeah. There's one coming in right down this edge here. So I'm going to wait for this one. Hopefully we'll get it right. Get that across there. Oh no. If it's not going right, stop it. Yeah, that was going a bit to the right of him. That's it. How has he missed that? That's right on his plumbing nose, that. That one is as well. Go on.
How's it about missing him?
He's still there. Oh, I don't know how he's missing him. Yeah, if it's not... Hey, oh, go on, the ducks. If it's not going right... That can be a sign of fish over there as well, folks. You know, obviously that duck spooking away. It's not going right when you're looking to cast it. Just stop it sort of mid-air so you don't spook it. Because the worst thing you can do is obviously put it over them and then spook them. And we don't want that. Another one coming in over here. More sort of to me right now, which you'd expect, obviously that wind going that way. We're still going to get the other one moving through though. Oh wait, it's one. It looks a babby one, but... Are you going to go for that? A bit too far away. Too far away. Let's have another go at him. Come on then, it's coming this way. Right, so we've got a couple swimming through now. Oh, there's one. I'm just going to have a go for this one first before I cast for them. Go on, right on it. Come on, it's right on it. Nope. Right, one of these should have it. It's like three coming in now. One of these should definitely have it. Oh, where have they gone? Where have they gone? Come on. Gone past it. We'll just drop down that little bit deeper then. And pull it back. Go on.
Ooh, he's spooked off it!
He went for it and spooked off it. Right, and put a normal pellet back on.
Gosh, it's frustrating this, folks,
but when they have it, it's like amazing and all hell breaks loose. It is good. Another one coming through over here. The one over there, he's worth a cast out over there. Ghosty, where? I can't see. Oh yeah. Go on then. Yeah, boy! Please tell me you got that, Jamie. Please tell me you got that. I don't think it's a ghosty though. I think it's that blooming F1's taking it. Oh, folks, I thought I had the ghosty then. So what's happening, and this is what always happens, there's always fish underneath ghosties. Obviously, they're the most visible fish. So you chuck at them, but it's very rare you catch them. Sometimes you do. It's always the fish underneath. Hey, oh, we're stuck on something. Oh, no, what's going on here? Stuck on something. That's it, it's come off. Probably branch off a tree or something. Yeah, very rare you catch them. It's always the fish underneath it that you don't see you end up catching, which is what we've got here. Another F1. Nice F1s, though, but obviously not what we want. Well, they are, no. I'm not going to diss the F1s. Love F1s, especially when they're that size. He's nailed it, isn't he? I have to remember that. That snag. Yeah, beautiful F1s. Beautiful. But we want big carps. I say that every time I've chucked it, carp, it's F1s that are having it. I thought I was that ghosty then, Jamie. You thought I was that ghosty then? Ugh. Right, so. I want to catch carp on this, folks. I'm going to keep going with it. But bearing in mind, probably how it is now, I would be on the more sort of traditional waggler, but we can cover that separately if we like. You know what I mean? What I'll be doing in matches is just obviously switching between the two lines. Or the two methods. Go on. Oh, he's turned for it. He's turned for it. Go on in. Go on in. Oh, judges! Oh, folks, you know what it does to me, this. I absolutely adore it, but it's so frustrating as well. So frustrating. There's another couple coming through over here, I can see, but I'm not going to touch them just yet. Ducks having most of my bait over there. Not that I'm bothered. Never get rid of ducks, folks. A bit too far away, that one. Oh, there's F1s everywhere in this bay. That's a big one over there. A bit more line. It's gone a bit farther away. Ding, ding, ding. Come on, the fishies. Fishies, fishies, fishies. Fishies, fishies, fishies. Just shows you can catch F1s with it. Here's me saying you don't bloody catch F1s with it as well because you missed too many. Not missed a bite off of one. Come on, he's a big one there. Come on. Oh. Oh, go on then. Go on then. Oh, they're just turning away. Turning away. I'm wondering if you need even longer up length on, maybe go to 4 foot, might be a little bit better. It could be sometimes. It might. They're not spooking off the noise of the float, which is good though. But they're just, obviously they're not eating it either. Look at me meerkatting. Meerkat, meerkat, meerkat. Meerkat, meerkat, meerkat. There's one. That's too far away though. You know, go for it. Yeah, it's too far away. They're just sort of like, you see them porpoising as well. As if they're like coming up for bait. Come on, the fishies, go on the caps. Nope, 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 nope. Don't get out your rhythm. Keep that bait going in. So important. If them F1s are feeding, I bet we'll have a few on that. We'll probably miss a few bites. Probably have a few on that traditional pellet waggler. Right, so I'm not seeing any now. Odd one, but nothing to warrant staying on this. They're F1s then. F1s. Every cart we put it to. I've had one go for it, I think. Every other one's just spooked off and just swam. Swam on by! Not walk on by, swam on by. No, not seeing nothing now. So I think it's a good time to end that one, and then we'll get on to our traditional pellet waggler. So what I'll do with this is change that bait again, leave it baited up, because as soon as they go, they can just appear again like that. So that one. Because I've been feeding this traditional pellet waggler for quite a bit of time, hopefully there should be some fish on it pretty quick. So let's see if we don't catch a duck. Here we go then. There's another F1, but there's quite a few over there swirling every time I go to cast in. I'm getting swirls right on top of it. So I've chucked it in the reeds twice, chucked it up the bank once. But so you've got to get tight. We are getting bites away, but you've got to get tight. This is right in that little gap. Look at the size of them F1s. Proper ones, them. Proper ones. Quite a few fish. Look at that beauty. Amazing F1s, them. Been quite a few sort of swimming through again, so I have to keep an eye out on that. It's a big ghost who'd have swum through before. I thought I'd have caught him, but we missed him. Never mind. So, changing that pellet every time as well, folks. Yeah, I don't want to be going in on that same bait. Keep a lookout. Feed. It's landed a bit short, but as I said, I'm not overly bothered at the minute. With it being a bit overcast, they are coming out of the banking a little bit. I just looked down at the wire and then we had a bloody bite. So they are sort of topping from sort of three quarters of the way over them fish. So, go for it again. Still got it set about 2 foot. Don't need to change that at the minute. I'm getting pretty much a bite every cast. That's it. Yeah, we got him. We got him, folks. Lovely fishing. So when you get it right, it's just superb. You've seen the difference, obviously, going on to this run, like that mugging waggler. Loads more bites on this and something to go for, you know what I mean? Whereas obviously that mugging waggler, it's purely sight. Still the odd, and there's one cruising near us at the minute. Let's see if he'll go for that. Nope, spook right off it. Mad, isn't it? You think they're good for it? I think this one might be up where it shouldn't be, folks. Oh, that one, it's a great big one. You see, I'm playing them as well, everything nice and low all the time. I say, I always have bat wind on, but I'll have my drag set right, just in case. It's important as well, match, obviously it doesn't matter for today, but match conditions, keeping your bait going in. Keeping that going in. Lovely action on these rods, folks. Oh, superb. Awesome. Pull back a bit on here. They do. Oh, there's a carp. Oh, it's a little ghosty as well. Go on, he'll do. If that's the one that I saw close in. Wobbled its way over there to get some bait. I wonder if it's fighting a bit harder. Come on then. Oh. Oh, fucking ghosties. Go on then. That's a nice one, folks. First of many carp, hopefully. Put some bait in while he's thrashing around. So yeah, rod under your leg, and then obviously nice and under tension so that nothing can tangle. Just pay line off by the drag if you need to. Beautiful little ghosty mirror, that. Look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful. So, just been straight back in. So, we just stuck one on the. Well, no, we didn't hook one. We have just hooked one, but before that, just hooked some on the bottom over there. Got snarled up, didn't we, folks? There's a lot of fish there now. Again, still F1s. Amazing fishing this. Just. Oh! Bestest ever in the old wide world ever. F1s are massive! Not see. Oh, there's still. Odd one coming through now, but not as many as before. So with that sun going in, definitely feels as though they're feeding. I said there's tails coming up all the time over there. Not carp, definitely F1s. But with the size of them, we're not bothered. Oh, beautiful. Oh, it might be. Is it ghosty? Blow my neck. Turn the pace then. So I always have my drag set right. Obviously, I always use backwind, but always have my drag set just in case. It's like a little Bobby Ghosty. Oh no. Yeah! Oh, he's blooming stuff. He swam out there, folks. I reckon it's the same one he had before. Look at that beauty. Get him on. Get him on. Goodness sake, they're angry. Well, we need to get the hook out. Right, put that down there. Let me show you. Look at that beauty. Lovely little ghosty mirror. Yeah, boy! So they're up to sort of like 27 times that big in here, though. Huge things they are. But proper. Definitely feels as though they're feeding a bit now. That's it. It's like, you know that fishy weather, you know, when it goes like overcasting, muggy, and definitely having a chew now. Another bait on. It's geared to another bait on. Snarled up my sunglasses, that one. Got water all over my sunglasses, folks, you know what I mean? No good, is it? Get that out. Lovely, lovely. Feed first. Don't get the duck, don't get the duck. Oh, that's a good cast, that's right on it. Is it the clip come off that? The plumbing clip's come off that. I'm going to clip it up there. Is it? No. Look at them all on them reeds. So many fish over there now. Oh. So a lot of them are F1s, but odd carp as well. We'll have another cast with no feed, just because there's so many there. Don't want to keep, no, duck, don't want to keep that bait. See what I mean? Cast with no feed, it's like, took it straight, oh, he's in the reeds, he's in, no, he's not. He's over there, get down low, and he's fell off. Oh, has he fell off? No, he's not, oh, what is going on? I thought he'd fell off. Oh, it's all going on, folks, isn't it? But just shows you, obviously, cast with no feed, because no one's competing for these fish today. You know what I mean? So, I think it's another F1, but that's what it can be like. Instant. Literally, as soon as you're in, that's it, on. Definitely been through some reeds or something like that. Oh, look at the size of that for an F1. Easy. Look at that for a F1. Yeah, boy. Who needs carp when you're catching F1s like that? He's not really happy, though. Yep. Let me get the hook out of him. Oh, he's come out here. And let me show you the size of these F1s in here. Look at the size of that for a F1. 5 pounds. 6 ounce, look at that beauty. Yeah, boy. Stunning, isn't it? It shows you how quickly you can do a weight with fish like that. Nailed it straight away, him. Glad I didn't put my over trousers on, folks. Not slimy in the slightest. Let's get that tank out. It's better. Yeah, just goes to show, not just feed all the time, simply because you're just going to get too many fish in your peg. And likewise, match conditions, you know, if there's not a lot of people feeding around you, then you don't need to feed as much. You know, obviously that just, well, it showed it then, just homed in on that noise straight away. And that's what'll happen. It's such a noise-dominated method, this. Absolutely adored it. I was convinced that fish had fell off then. Thought it found the reeds and fell off. Still on that. It's nailing them pellets as soon as you go in. Oh, here we go. That's got to be one on that. Got to be. Come on. Ah, oh, how can that not go? Nope, not having it. Nope. Don't leave it too long, folks. Don't leave it too long. It's alright. Definitely got the leads down feed. I'm not noticing anything cruising though. Come on. Go on if you cheese. Swirl right by it. Nope. Oh, just about to come back then. Well, I say there's nothing crew. I've just seen two crews past here. I'm on the wrong rod. I'm gonna have a go for them. So I've not had any of these big carp take it at all yet. Nope. Andrew, that is poor. Try again. Oh, that's a one. Go on then. Go on then. Oh, you bastard! Oh, I can't believe that didn't take it proper then. It's as if they're sort of coming to it, nosing it, and then just swimming away. They're definitely not taking it proper. I reckon I'd have got that on me mugging one. Go on, that's got to go. Go on then. Yeah, but... Oh! God, it's proper this now, folks. So cast with no feed. Definitely come to that noise, aren't they? They love it. Yep, go on then. Oh, I took it straight away, then it fell off. Fell off that one, folks. Not what we want, but it'll happen. You can get it. That bait's all right. Yeah, boy, you've seen the difference, ain't you? Again, that was no feed. All F1s, though. Obviously, that's why we're missing a few, because so many F1s over there. But even so, fabulous day sport, isn't it? Absolutely fabulous day sport. Adore it, I do. See why I like it so much, folks, can't you? Just amazing. Amazing. I'll take them off now. That's better, I can see you proper now. Amazing fishing. Yeah, boy. Oh, there's lots of carp, little babby carps, another little babby mirror. Ugh, angry, angry, angry. Little Bobby Mirror. Ugh, come here. Little Bobby Mirror. Beautiful. Oh, like ghosty mirrors. This must be like ghosty corner, this or something. Normally you don't catch any. Well, I don't catch any big ghosties in here anyway, but I've not had any ghosties, I don't think, out there before. Didn't realise there were that many in. Right. Yeah. Right. Let's catch one more then. As I say, I've covered both tactics, obviously. Without this is going now, you'd never come off this, but you've still got to have a go for them. No, that's rubbish. Big carp when they rock up and you start seeing them. I mean, if you don't, you don't miss out on them because some of them are massive. Gonna go. Yeah. How can it not go? How can it not go? Oh no. Oh, take a clip off. Take a clip off. Oh dear. Oh dear, 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 dear. I don't know where he's going, folks, but he's not very happy. He's not very happy. But it's a blooming F1 as well. Knew it was going to go. So many fish over there. Just shows you. There you can have, innit? Amazing. Absolutely amazing. I reckon it's a big F1, you know. One of ones. Definitely not very happy. Normally you get him under your rod tip like that, they're normally done. Ooh, head shake them folks. Oh, you won't be happy then. Oh yeah, nice chunky one. These are what we've come for. I thought we'd have had these mugging though, it just shows you, doesn't it? Just shows you. As I said, definitely started. They're still turning up there now. Definitely started showing well now. Some right action on that rod, folks. Ugh. Come on, the fishies. Big carps. Big chunky mirror. Go on. Oh, he didn't like that net. Did you see him then? Oh, my neck, he didn't like that net then. That was well angry. He's like, no, thank you. I'm not going in there. You're not going in there, he says. Come on. Come on. I don't know when to give up these fish. So angry. Oh, it's not even a blooming mirror either. It's a popular. Well, I reckon, folks, we're going to end on that one. Beautiful carp, I'll just show you. It's a bit lively, but. Nailed it. Oh, nailed it straight away. Come here. So angry after spawning. So I reckon, as I say, we'll end on that one. A lovely, I'm gonna give myself £8 for that one. Definitely £8 mirror. Look at that for a popular. Eesh, beautiful. So get it safely returned, and then all that's left is to say, get out and give the Pellet Waggler a go. You know, find a lake, loads of carp, loads of F1s in. And just follow what I've done. Been nothing complicated with it, but you've seen, bearing in mind sort of match conditions, just you've got to be wary of, obviously, if you're using that sort of like mugging as a tactic, you've got to be wary of it. As soon as you go sort of like them few goes when you make at them without seeing a fish, come off it and, you know, get on the actual, you know, traditional way of fishing the Pellet Waggler. It's been noticeable today that as soon as that sun's gone in, the fish have proper started having a chew. They're still there's still tails coming up over there now, you know what I mean, on my leftover bait and what have you, and obviously there's not a lot of people doing it around you. You're just going to have it all to yourself and you're just going to get more and more fishing. Bearing in mind, obviously, 12, 15 second at the most casts on this style of fishing, because you've seen, like, we've not had a bite on the bottom, or if we have, we've potentially foul hooked it and just hooked something winding back. All your fish usually come within sort of, I'm going to say 5 seconds, and they almost sort of hook themselves. But yeah, get out there, folks, give it a go, and let me know how you get on. Yeah!